Not.
Good morning, my dear friends. Today, let us continue the exercise that is 11.1. Yesterday, we have solved 6 problems related to this chapter. So, today, let us begin from question number 7. See, the question is like this. If cot theta equal to 7 by 8, evaluate 1 plus sin theta, 1 minus sin theta, whole divided by 1 plus cos theta, 1 minus cos theta, second cot square theta. Okay? Now let us begin the solution. See, this one is the right angle triangle, angle A, B, C. Okay, what they have given? Cot theta equals to 7 by 8. Cot theta, adjacent side. Adjacent side for this diagram is this one, adjacent side, 7. Then divided by opposite side. This one is opposite side. So, we have to find the remaining length, that is AC square. In triangle ABC, angle B equals to 90 degree. So, AC square equals to AB square plus BC square. So, AB square is nothing but 7 square plus 8 square. 49 plus 64. That is 13, carry 1, 1, 3. That is AC square equals to 113. Therefore, AC equals to square root of 113. AC square equals to, see, cot theta they have given, adjacent side is an AB, opposite side is AD. So, AC will be square root of 113. Now we have to find, evaluate the sin theta. That means we need to find sin theta. Sin theta equals to, sin theta equals to opposite side divided by, opposite side divided by, that is hypotenuse, that is BC by AC. BC by AC, which is equal to, that is BC 8 divided by square root of 113. Then cos theta we need, cos theta equals to adjacent side AB divided by hypotenuse, that is AC, which is equal to 8 divided by AB, 7 divided by, that is square root of 113. Now, 1 plus sin theta, into 1 minus sin theta, divided by 1 plus cos theta, into 1 minus cos theta, equals to 1 plus sin theta into cos theta, 1 minus sin theta, 1 minus sin square theta. 1 plus cos theta minus 1 minus cos theta, 1 minus cos square theta. Okay? 1 minus sin square theta. See, sin square theta, sin is 8 divided by square root of 113 whole square. That is equal to 1 minus cos theta, 7 divided by root of 113 whole square, which is equal to 1 minus 64 divided by 113 divided by 1 minus 7, 1 minus 49 equal to 113. So, after simplification, see, LCM is 113. 113 is a Panja minus 64 divided by LCM 113 minus 49. Okay, 113 minus 64. 113 minus 64. This is 49. You can also substitute the values of sin theta in this case also. Here 1 plus sin theta, 1 plus 8 divided by 113. Here also 1 cos theta, 7 by 113. But we have used here the identities a plus b, a minus b, a square minus b square, 1 minus sin square theta. 1 plus cos theta, 1 minus cos theta. A square minus B square, 1 minus cos square theta. So 1 minus sin square theta, that value is substituted. Here value is substituted. After simplification, we have 49 divided by 64 is the answer for this question, the first one. Then automatically for second question, cos square theta is equal to 7 by 8. So we have to substitute the values, then we got 49 by 64 as its answer. Okay, write down.
You write down.
Now this one is the yield problem. We have to check whether 1 minus tan square a whole divided by 1 plus tan square a is equal to cos square a minus sin square a. We have to check by considering that values. If 3 cot a equals to 4 given, 3 cot a equals to 4, therefore cot a equals to 4 by 3. Cot A equals to 4 by 3. Let us set this value in the diagram. A, B, C. Cot A, adjacent side divided by opposite side. Adjacent side divided by opposite side. Okay? This angle. Okay, now in triangle ABC, angle B equals to 90 degree. Angle B equals to 90 degree. So AC square equals to AB square plus BC square. Okay, AB that is 4 square plus 3 square, 16 plus 9, which is equals to 25. AC equals to square root of 25. Then AC equals to 5. Then this value is 5. Okay. Now let us find the tan theta, sin theta, cos theta. Now sin theta. That is sin A. Opposite side divided by hypotenuse. BC divided by AC. BC divided by AC. That is 3 by 5. Then cos theta. That is cos A. Equals to adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. That is AC. So 4 by 5. Tan theta. Equals to opposite side divided by BC divided by adjacent side AB. So this is 3 by 4. Now let us find the value of 1 minus tan square A. Now 1 minus tan square A divided by 1 plus tan square A. 1 minus tan square A, tan A is 3 by 4 whole square. 1 plus 3 by 4 whole square. That is equal to 1 minus 9 by 16. 1 plus 9 by 16. That is equal to LCM 16. 16 minus 9. Here LCM is 16. Here also 16 plus 9. Okay. Now 16 minus 9. 7 by 16. 4 divided by 25 by 16. 25 by 16. That means 7 by 16 into 16 by 25. Okay, 16, 16 cancel. The value we got is 7 divided by 25. Its value tan 1 minus tan square plus whole divided by 1 plus tan square. 7 divided by 25. Then cos square minus sin square. Cos square is 4 by 5. Sin square 3 by 5. 16 divided by 25 minus 9 divided by 25. LCM is 25. 1 that is 16 minus 9, which is equal to 7 divided by 25. Therefore, 1 minus tan square A divided by 1 plus tan square A equals to cos square A minus sin square A. That's 7 by 25. 7 by 25. See once again, this one is the first part. Then this will continue here. Okay, write down. See, this one is the ninth question. In triangle ABC, angle B equals to 90 degree. If tan A equals to 1/√3, find the value of sin A cos C plus cos A sin C. Then cos A cos C minus sin A sin C. Okay. Now we have to consider a triangle. Angle B, angle A, angle C. Okay, tan A, opposite side divided by adjacent side. Opposite side 1, then opposite side 1, then adjacent side root 3. Okay, in triangle ABC, angle B equals to 90. AC square equals to AB square plus BC square. AB root 3 whole square plus BC 1 square. Root 3 square means 3, 1, that is 4. Therefore, AC equals to square root of 4. AC equals to 2. AC equals to 2. Now let us find the values of sin A cos A. Sin A, opposite side divided by hypotenuse. BC by AC, that is 1/2. Then cos A equals to adjacent side divided by hypotenuse AC. Cos A adjacent side divided by hypotenuse root 3 divided by 2. Then sin C, sin C is here, that is opposite side AB divided by hypotenuse AC, that is equals to root 3 divided by 2. Cos C equals to cos C adjacent side BC divided by AC, that is 1/2. Okay, these are the values obtained by utilizing this diagram. First of all, we have to find the value of this unknown length, that is AC. So by using the Pythagoras theorem, we found that AC equals to 2. AC equals to 2. Then sin A, opposite side divided by hypotenuse. Opposite side, that is BC divided by AC, that is 1/2. Cos A, adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. AB divided by AC, root 3/2. Then sin C, this is opposite side, that is AB divided by hypotenuse, that is root 3/2. Then cos C, adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. Adjacent side, this one, BC by AC. So 1/2. Now let us find the values. First one, sin A cos C plus cos A sin C, that is equals to sin A 1/2 into cos C 1/2 plus cos A root 3/2. Then the sin C cos A root 3 by sin C root 3/2. 1 into 1 2 2 are 4 plus root 3 into root 3 3 3 divided by 2 2 are 4, that is equal to LCM is 4 1 plus 3 which is equals to 4 by 4 that is equals to 1. 4 ones are 4 ones that is equals to 1. First answer is 1. Then the second one, cos A into cos C minus sin A into sin C. Okay, see, cos A into cos C minus sin A into sin C. Cos A root 3 by 2 into cos C 1 by 2 minus sin A 1 by 2 into sin C root 3 by 2. Okay, root 3 by 2 to the 4 minus root 3 by 2 to the 4. Root 3 by 4, root 3 by 4 gets cancelled, that is equal to 0. Second value will be 0. Okay. Now I will repeat once again. What they have given? They have given tan A equals to 1 by root 3. So that has been settled in the diagram. So after for settling those values, then we have to find the length of AC. By using the Pythagoras theorem, we calculated AC as 2. Then we have applied the rules related to sin A, in which position angle A is existing, like that sin A equals to BC opposite side divided by hypotenuse, like that all the values are calculated by using this diagram. Then the values are substituted in the questions. So in first question we got 1 as the answer, in second question we got 0. Okay, now observe the solution. Okay, this one is the question number 8. What actually this question reads? In triangle PQR, right angle at Q. That is right angle at Q. So, okay, let us draw the diagram. The right angle triangle. Right angle at Q. Then PR plus QR equals to 25. Let PQR equals to X. Therefore, PR plus QR equals to 25. PR plus QR equals to 25. PR plus X equals to 25. Therefore, PR equals to 25 minus X. PR equals to 25 minus X. Okay. This one has X. In triangle PQR, angle Q equals to 90 degree. Okay, angle Q equals to 90 degree. Then according to Pythagoras theorem, PR square equals to PQ square plus QR square. PR square 25 minus X whole square. PQ square 5 square plus QR, that is X square. Now solving this bracket, A minus B whole square, A square 25 plus B square X square minus 2AB, 225 is a minus 50X equals to 5 square 25 plus X square. Okay, now let us transpose the variable terms, that is 625 minus 25 equals to X square, this plus X square minus X square, this minus 50X plus 50X. Okay, plus X square minus X square gets cancelled. 625 minus 25, 600 equals to 50X we got. Then x equals to 600 divided by 50. 0 0 cancel, 5 1 5 12, so x equals to 12. X is nothing but qr equals to 12. Then we want PR plus, we know PR plus QR equals to 25. QR is 12, that is 25. PR equals to 25 minus 12. Therefore, PR equals to 25 minus 12, 13. Okay? PR is 13. Now, let us set one more diagram which indicates the exact values what we obtain. That is, in triangle PQR, we have the values like PQ5, then where is that X? 20, 13, then second one is 12, that is QR. QR we got is, that is 12, then QP5, then PR 13. Now, let us find what they have asked us. Sine P. Sine P equals to opposite side divided by hypotenuse, that is QR by PR equals to 12 divided by 13. Then cos P equals to adjacent side PQ divided by hypotenuse PR equals to 5 divided by 13. Then tan P equals to opposite side divided by adjacent side QR divided by PQ, which is equals to QR is 12, PQ is 5, 12 by 5. These are the required values according to the question what they have asked. See, the first integral PQ right angle at Q, PR plus QR is 25 and PQ equals to 5. One angle is given, but another value is given indirectly. So we have considered that considering X as one of the side, then we have calculated the PR as 25 minus X. Then by applying the by applying that PR plus QR equals to 25. We want PR, so PR plus 12 is 25. PR equals to 25 minus 12, that is PR equals to 30. Then the value based diagram. Here Q is a right angle, right Q. So symbol of right angle. So sine B, that is opposite side divided by hypotenuse, QR by PR. Then cos P, adjacent side divided by hypotenuse, that is PQ by PR. Then 5 by 13, then that P equals to QR by PQ equal by 5. Okay? Right now. See, one more thing I want to inform you, that some of you are not taking the CC book for writing the FA1 and FA2 test, as well as third project work is given. So please come to the school and take your CC book and complete the work whatever the teacher is given. Okay, without fail, come and collect your CC books. Thank you.